All right, boys. Yes, sir. Welcome back to another video. Listen, today I have the gem guide finally. This video was supposed to drop on Friday and I completely missed it. In today's video, though, you guys have literally been asking me for the gem guide forever since, you know, Purgatory Ban was revealed. I've had over at least 100 people saying, yo, where the gem guide at, bro? Where the gem guide at? And again, on stream, I asked, like, yo, are you guys ready for another one? And you guys definitely said yes. So, here today, I went and updated this as much as I could. I literally went and pulled out everything I could from everywhere regarding patch notes and all of that stuff. I did, in fact, leave the Purgatory Ban freebies out of this because I question how they're going to do it for us, given it won't actually be our 1.5-year anniversary in time for when this drops. So with that being said, I didn't include the Purgatory Ban freebies, but overall this does cover every single gem you can acquire by the time Ban leaves global. If you haven't already, make sure you leave a like on this video. These ones take forever, so I really do appreciate everyone that leaves a like on this one. I'll definitely go for a solid 350 likes. Let's see if we can crack it. If you're new to the channel, you haven't already subscribed, consider doing so because it really does help me out a ton. With no further delay, let's jump straight into this and talk about all the gems we can acquire. So there we go, on screen you guys are taking a look at what we got here today. This is in fact what the gem guide is looking like. Overall, given from this one to our previous one, it's been almost 14 days. It's been a while since I actually recorded a gem guide, which is, yay, it is pretty shocking. Usually I record these every week, but I did skip last week because I didn't do a video for Zeldris. I felt like it wasn't that important. I told most people do not summon for it, and I wanted to make sure that no one went and summoned for it. But overall, the amount of people that summoned for Zeldris, again, you know, you can do what you want with the gems, but overall, yeah, I would say it wasn't the greatest purchase or the greatest investment of gems. Most of the people that went and summoned for Chandler, and they didn't get that after their 900 gems, they went into the banner. And now you kind of went 900 down and there's Chandler going to be on the next banner, which is the second anniversary. I know people are going to say it was on rate up, bro. What are you talking about? It's practically the same rate. It's a 0.05% down. It's not really that important. I will say though, yeah, it wasn't the greatest call, but it is what it is. You want to do what you want with the gems, go for it. If you like the unit so much that you couldn't live without it, that is fine. You have another chance to pull it, so don't you worry. Use this time wisely, go and grind with the gems, and again, have fun with the Purgatory Bond banner. I already know there are so many people hyping that banner up, and again, it's hype well deserved, bro. Bond has been shafted completely. His banner, or just overall, his unit was horrible. He now has the greatest unit in the game. He now has the greatest banner in the game. Overall, they did my boy Bond real good now. So first of all, let's talk about dates. For everyone wondering really quickly, where are we on? We're currently practically about to finish the first week, which is in fact 524, right? That is where we are on right now. At the time of recording, we are on 530. So tomorrow, right, when we get the patch notes and all of that beautiful stuff, we will in fact get 531. This will be the newest update. We'll get those gems. So accordingly, right, if we follow the entire method right here, this is how much we got this week. 137 gems, which is a very, very nice update. They added some more specials in over here. We had a great time. I would say overall it was a fun update. Yes, a very very smaller one, I guess you could say. Now, take the back. We got Belmos, which is big. We got the deathmatch, which was amazing. Again, I still enjoy Perrin Pool a lot. Yes, they shouldn't have put a cap on it. The 5 cap annoys me so much. I kind of want to do conquest more, and I hate getting invited with randoms. I was just trying to chill and just, you know, invite some people, hang out, and like actually do conquest properly. But like overall, it gives 5. It's kind of eh. I do enjoy it. Yes, I will say if it was more than 5, oh, it would have been the greatest. But we also have final boss over here. Which one would that be? It'll probably be Derry if they do care to drop that right away. Knowing Dent Marble, we can actually push that one back. But if they do push it back, we have to get it before Bond. So overall, we should be fine. Okay, they won't push it back. It practically is meant to be dropped on that date, just like how they've done everything. So I will say for certain, we should be fine on that one. Also, before Purgatory Bond drops, who actually knows if we do get a final boss? So out of all of this, we might have to deduct 43 gems, and we still have to add on like a free multi, a few other things. There are so many freebies in the newest update that probably you can add it all together and get about 100 gems. I will say so, 100 gems seems about the right amount. There was like 30 from a multi, there was 10 for logging in, there was another check-in thing, they had a deathmatch event thing, there was like a, what is it? I think it was like the crocodile. It was a crocodile, right? They had that event, so many things for you guys to go and claim some gems. So I will say you will be fine. Again, this is worst case scenario. We're also missing a few gems from the Excalibur Earthen event. I don't know what Netmarble will drop for that because again, they do mess around with the events. We didn't expect Perrin Pool to drop. I don't believe so. With that being said, who knows what drops, right? We did get like the school costumes, we got them for free, we got a lot of things with this update, but overall, they kind of switched things here and there. So in the end, this is what we got, okay? On 524 to 531, you guys can go and claim 137 gems, 146 gems. After that, we probably go and expect over here on 67, 614 will be Excalibur Arthur. 621, 628, 675, and 712 will in fact be when Purgatory Ban hits global. So be ready for those dates. That will 100% be how it goes for us. And again, it is going to be very, very hyped over here on global. I know people are saying, yo, the game is going down, the game is dying. No, it's not. It literally is going to be a very hyped event in what, 3 weeks? So we have time. We have some time to save some gems. And for everyone scared that they're not going to be able to make it, by the time, so if you count up this day onwards, you can get about 1,078 gems. Let's say you spent these gems, that's why this final total doesn't show this, because you could have went and spent these gems on Zeldris or on something else, maybe the costumes that were in the shop, which were the, the school costumes that are currently in the shop, maybe you spent on those, so I will deduct this one. But if we go off worst case, starting from 531 until the banner leaves, you will 100% be able to make a full rotation, walking away with about a minimum of 938 gems, right? That is a good amount. That will almost guarantee you everything. Again, it is worst case scenario, right? Let's say there was 43 gems taken away just by that. You can easily add on another 100 for the Purgatory Bond banner or the Purgatory Bond event. They also had some free multis. I don't know, again, if those free multis actually count towards the banner itself or that fever banner. I will check that out for you guys. On JP, I didn't actually scroll and check. I thought I just automatically took me to a fever banner. I think it does work on the Bond banner. Someone said so. I will check that out and just make sure that I'm correct about it. Also, by the way, you only need 870 gems to summon on the Bond banner. This is the first festival ever, practically, you know, not a Holy War festival, a regular festival that does include a free multi with a banner. So the only catch to that is they did in fact take away the free unit, right? We did expect to see one. Instead of giving us a free unit, they gave us a free multi. Take it however you will. Maybe that free multi actually gets you something. If it doesn't, you kind of got shafted. You know, I really would have liked to see at least a free unit. I am telling you now, and I will always stand by this entire point. I could be wrong, and you'll tell me that I'm wrong, but I really feel like Excalibur Arthur was supposed to be the free unit, and they just didn't actually give it, right? They just said, you know what? He's going to be his own banner. Screw you. That's practically what they said. So let's say you guys are at a solid, currently I'm at like 700 gems, right? I'm at 700. I'm going to have 1159 by the time Arthur ends. Let's say I have 700 in time for the second anniversary. I'm going to walk away with a whopping 1638 gems by the end of it. So I could, in fact, if I wanted to, make a second rotation and then hope that I get extra luck on it. I won't be able to complete it. Yes, I will be able to pick up some freebies over here if I add on that 100 and then I use that free multi, and maybe if I have those fever multis that are for free. If you guys are at a whopping 200 gems, you guys are going to be sitting on a fat 659 and a 1138. So overall, practically speaking, if you have just 200 gems right now, you can go on the Excalibur Arthur banner, and you can go on the Purgatory Bond banner. So for anyone that cares about that, I'm just going to let you know that info, which seems pretty good. Yeah, maybe 152. If you're at like 150 gems right now, you can still make it. That'll be 609 in time for that. That'll be 11. Oh, so that'll be 1008 for this. Also, I'm not taking in count for the fact that, you know, we all got 100 gems back from ReZero. Let's say you did get that 100 gems back. I got 100 back, so I'm chilling. So with that added in, that does help you out even more. I'm going to quickly go and calculate some more totals. Let's say you're at 500. You're at 959 in time for that. Let's say you're 500 here. Let's say you're at 100 real quick. Again, 559 for anyone wondering. And then, yes, practically, if you're at 0 gems right now, you'll still be able to make it. Let's just say you're really lucky and you have not 100, but 1,000 gems. With that being said, that means, boom, you're going to be at a solid 1938 and a 1459. So, practically, if you have more than 800 gems or 700 gems right now, you can make two rotations on the banner if you're looking for that. Overall, though, that has been the entire gem guide. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on everything. Are you guys ready for the Purgatory Bond banner? Are you going to be skipping it? Are you just going to go and say, screw it, two rotations in, I'm going all out, I love Bond. Whatever, just, you know, you love the banner, whatever it is, you're just going to go and summon until you can't. Let me know how you guys are going to take care of that. That's really been it for me. For anyone wondering, my plan, definitely one rotation on Bond is how I'm looking at it. If I'm lucky enough, maybe I will go a second one. I'll take a look at what's next. Practically, we will know what is coming up for Grand Cross. Right after that, maybe it is, in fact, Holy War Estrossa, and he'll be the counter to Bond. I will keep you guys up to date when that does drop, but yeah, that's looking like what we got. Thank you again for watching. Make sure you leave a like, subscribe, notifications on. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I'm out. Laters!